The winner of Tusker Project Fame 6 will receive a grand cash prize of 5 million Kenyan shillings sponsored by Tusker and a one-year recording contract with Sony Music. Terms and conditions apply.
The winner is Valerie.
The winner of Tusker Project Fame is Esther!
And the winner is Alpha! Is Davis. Davis.
Ruth.
Africa, what's happening? My name is Dr. Ronnie Michigwang, and this is the lovely Joey Muthengi.
Why, thank you.
Yes, and j'aimerais vous dire bonsoir à tout le monde du Burundi et du Rwanda. Ce soir, c'est super 100%.
I flunked out of French class, but I'm sure knowing that it's you, something about women or chickens, beautiful women maybe. I don't know.
Okay. Anyways, what I was just saying is that tonight is eviction night. That means that at the end of the night, somebody's going to be going home.
Yes. Can you believe that we are halfway through this competition? And next week, it's your votes and your votes only that are going to determine who stays in the Tusker Project Fame Academy.
Yep. But let me tell you something. It's a big but. Because now this week is difficult. Last week, believe it or not, the faculty decided to revoke the voting rights. I thought this was a democracy.
No, not really.
They decided to say, no, you can't vote. No, this, I don't know. Tell me something. Principal Eric Wainaina, AKA Principal Y, are you guys going to pull the same stance again this week?
No, today we're going to vote. And we know who we're going to
vote for.
You're sure?
Yes.
So basically, we should just go to the end of the show.
No, what it means is that you have to stay tuned to find out who's going to stay in the Tusker Project Fame Academy and who is not. Because last week, as Mitch was saying, Jennifer from Kenya and Angel from Tanzania were both sent packing. The faculty decided nobody deserved to go back into the academy.
Okay, and speaking about people who are on probation, AKA the hot seat, people who are sweating right now in the academy, let's give it up for our main man from Rwanda, Patrico! Our superstar sweetheart from Kenya, Nyambura! Ladies and gentlemen, the sweetheart from the Pearl of Africa, Sidenda! And yes, ladies and gentlemen, the man who's soon becoming the king of probation. Let's give it up for Bior from South Sudan.
Yeah, so, you know, Bior's been on probation a couple of times, but no matter how much fun it is to be on probation, to go shopping and go on media visits and ride in a limo, it's still a dangerous place to get comfortable at, because at the end of this hour, somebody is going to be sent packing and will be leaving the Tusker Project Fame Academy.
Yep, and if you're excited and you're thinking maybe you could throw in a couple of votes to probably get them off probation, nope, voting lines are closed. They're going to only open up tomorrow at 9 p.m. But for now, I think let's understand who put them, first of all, on probation. Ladies and gentlemen, since our main man, Hermes Bariki, is still the music director this week, I think let's start off with, oh yes, the lovely Atemi Oyungo. And then, ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about that beautifully delicious young lady, the lovely Juliana Kanyomozi. And next up, ladies and gentlemen, I'm actually confused because, okay, let's first introduce him. Let's say hi to Judge Ian Mbugwa. But hold on, wait.
What were you gonna say?
Wait. First of all, look, Ian,
yes.
You're wearing pink and Juliana's wearing pink. Yeah? Now, I'm wondering, what's happening here? Can I start singing, Ian and Juliana sitting on a tree. K-I-S-S-I-N-G. First comes love, then comes.
Yo, I just really don't think you should be singing at all.
Okay. It's a singing show.
No, it's a singing show, but that's not your job. That's their job.
Okay,
so let's leave that alone. We've got to welcome our faculty. Principal Eric Wainaina is back with us in the house. Welcome, Eric. Okay. And next to him, we've got our lovely voice coach, Kavuda Mwanzia Sio. And the main man, Edu, the guy who has contestants sweating every day, losing weight. That boot camp is serious, Edu. Welcome to the show. Not to forget our music director for this past week, Hermes Bariki, the hits. All right, and on the keys tonight, we've got Mr. Crucial Keys, Aaron Rimbui. And he's going to be joined by the band a little bit later on tonight for some eviction action.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this is Tusker Project Fame, Season 6. It's a competition.
Okay, so here we are with Patrick from Rwanda, and this is your first time on probation this week. So how's it been for you?
Yeah, it's been, let me say, it's been good for me. It was a big opportunity for me to meet with my fans, to sing for them. Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, so, you know, I was watching you as you're doing your media visits and stuff, and, you know, they're asking whether you're single or what's happening. You said you're single in the house, but is there somebody back home, maybe, who's been watching?
Actually, I was waiting for you.
Can you? You're waiting for me?
Yeah.
Oh, don't mess with me. I'm single, honey. Yes.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
But let's take a look at what put Patrick on probation in the first place.
Yeah. I'll never be something I'm not. Please don't throw away what we've got. Because we've been together for way too long. I was playing around, but I'm coming home.
I have to be honest, we all like you, but I don't think this was your best performance. I think you were given a really good song, but I think it was a bit challenging on you vocally.
Okay, Patrick there, and that's what landed him on probation. But Judge Ian last week said that you had too much going on stage. You know, you had tricks and props and things like that. Did you agree with that statement?
Yeah, I do. I try to reduce and to cut off those things. So now I think I'm bringing something simpler and nicer. Yeah.
Focusing on the music tonight.
Yeah.
All right, well, here he is performing John Legend's Number One. One more time, it's Patrick from Rwanda.
Ooh, I promise not to do it again. Yeah. Oh, you can't say I don't love you just because I cheat on you. As you can't see all I do to keep you from knowing the things I do. Like I raise my phone and keep it out of town. I get stripped up and I sleep around. What I should know one day you find out. You can go and leave me now. Oh, there's no one above you. I
Patrick from Rwanda back in business tonight. Let's start with our judges. Atemi, what did you think?
Well, I think that in comparison to last week, this was a lot better. You focused a lot on the singing in the beginning, and I think you did better, so that was really good.
Okay, over to Judge Juliana.
You know what? I think you're back to number one. Last week, I'm thinking maybe one of the problems you had last week was you had too much going on stage, and I guess you didn't give so much attention to the vocals. Now that you were just singing, you were back to number one.
Thank you.
So, Judge Ian, do you agree with the ladies? Did he improve?
It's a pity today that the music was much louder than you. I'd have liked to hear your mic a lot louder. But if you had performed like that on last week, you would not have been on probation.
Thank you.
All right, over to Hermes.
Yeah. Patrick, I think the only thing that got you on probation last week was the part that you forgot your lyrics. I liked your performance last week, and today is even much better. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And Principal Eric?
You're a great singer. Man, fantastic job.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Patrick, is there anything that you want to say to the faculty and the judges?
Actually, thank you for the probation opportunity that you gave me. Because I've been transformed by this, and I know I promise I'm going to make all my to give all my best to do what you want.
Thank you, Patrick. Well done.
All right, it's Tusker Project Fame Season 6. And tonight, you know, since it's a relaxed show, you know, you got to be able to sit back and chill. I've been checking social media here, and you can actually follow me on Twitter at Dr. M-I-C-H-E-R. And I've been checking a couple of tweets, and people are tweeting not about the show, but they're saying, the guy called George Bryan, I hear Mitch, come on, man. From last week's killer suit, and you come to with looking wearing this shirt, you look like you're going golfing, huh? Now, dude, you need to understand swag. Even if I was to wear a paper bag, I can rock it, huh? So learn these things, man. But this show is not about me, it's about performances. After the break, we got our main man, Bior from South Sudan, huh? And we've also got Sitenda from Uganda. It's all happening on Tusker Project Fame Season 6. All right, Tusker Project Fame Season 6. And, you know, I think today's show is also a little bit about getting to know the contestants a bit better. And I'm here with Sitenda. And if you would like to ask a couple of questions, we still got interviews with Bior coming up in Nyambura. Send them on Twitter and Facebook. But tell me something, Sitenda. Mm-hmm. All right. I want to do a special thing. It's called three questions. Huh?
Okay.
I'm just going to drop three quick questions. You give me your answers. Huh?
Okay.
All right, let's start with the first one. First mm-hmm. one. If you came back in another life as an animal, which animal would you be?
A peacock.
A what?
Peacock.
Peacock.
Mm-hmm.
But you're even darker than me. You'd be a black peacock, huh?
Huh? But Mitch, look at my red hair and my yellow dress.
Oh, yes. That one, like, I agree. Most definitely. All right. If you had a chance to rewind time and go mm-hmm. back in the past and change one thing about your life, what would it be?
I would go to music school.
Ah, mm-hmm. but you're talented already. What do you want to do with that?
I don't know. Just learn all the instruments in the world.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, so just a quick question here. Dr. Mitch or Judge Ian? Answer the question.
Mitch Ian?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's that the indecisiveness, which got her on probation last week.
Huh? I said Mitch Ian.
Sitenda.
I said Ian.
I want Ian loudly. Let's hear it.
Judge Ian.
Thank you.
all right. So, I wish you had taken her off probation. Now she's on probation. Let's take a look at why she got on last week. Take a look at this.
I know what you sound like. I know what you can do. I don't know whether it's just the wrong song for you, but I also know that you have issues with high notes, sweetheart. This was just not your best performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, doing a song from Fantasia, Bittersweet. Let's give it up for Sitenda from Uganda. Let's hit straight to the judges. Juliana, what do you think of the performance?
Now that's the Sitenda I missed last week. You know, no matter how talented one is, sometimes you need a few people to push you around and put you under pressure. And I think the pressure has brought out the best in you. I loved it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Uh-huh. Ian, your sweetheart said something. Do you agree with her since you're both wearing the same color?
Mitch.
Yes, Ian?
Get a life.
Okay.
Sitenda, you started off in a shy way, but as the song progressed, you got more and more confident. You need a lot more confidence. You are very talented. You've got something in you, but you're still holding back. Don't hold back.
Okay. Voice coach Kavutha.
Yes?
What do you think?
I think it was good. I like the fact that she internalized the song and Sitendified it. And it came across. I mean, you took the song and made it your own, which is what any singer should do. It was good.
Okay. All right. Great. So Aaron, what's your perspective about it?
I think that it's way better than last week. Great job, Sitenda.
All right. Yeah. Congratulations, great job, Sitenda.
Okay, so I'm hanging out with another one of my homies, Bior from South Sudan. Are you the king of probation? Are you the president? Who owns this club?
No, I'm not the president, but I'm the vice president.
Actually, Fez is the president.
Fez is the president, I'm the vice president.
Yeah, so yeah. How is the probation club treating
you? You know, we got the government. Yeah, we got the government.
We got the government on lock.
Actually, probation was really, it was another opportunity for me, second opportunity to meet my fans. I performed for them. It brushed me a little bit. So it was a lot of fun.
Rode in a limo, had a good time.
Rode in a limo, had a great time around the city.
Yeah.
You know, it was really fun.
So last week, Judge Ian was saying that you should just stop singing and start focusing on a rap career. You think if this doesn't work out for you, you're going to go back to South Sudan and drop an album, a rap album?
I am not going to drop just a rap album. I'm going to drop a lot of things. I'm going to do dancing. I'm going to do singing because I'm a singer.
If I wasn't a singer,
I couldn't be here.
I wouldn't be here if I wasn't a singer. Let's find out first what put you on probation again this week.
It sounded like it was too high for you and you were straining. May I suggest you stick to rapping and comedy? Just forget singing. Just do rap and comedy and you'll be fine.
Well, he has not stopped singing. He's an all-around entertainer. It's Bior from South Sudan. One more time singing Chris Brown's She Ain't You. Please welcome Bior. From the judges at Temi?
Well, you did a lot less stuff, and I think that you focused more on the singing, and that was good. There was still a couple of pitch issues, but then I'm glad that I got you before Ian, because singing and dancing and comedy, that makes you an entertainer, okay? Doesn't matter what he says.
Let's hear from Judge Ian now.
As Temi said, you did a lot less comedy and dancing. Yeah. And I did hear one or two correct notes. I have to give credit where it's due. So,
thank you very much.
So, I may be going back to the US. Sorry.
Sudan.
Oh, okay. It's from Sudan. Yeah. Oh,
Sudan. You're not saying it right. Sudan.
Sorry.
Okay. Let's hear from Sudan. Hermes right now.
Hey, Bior. What's up?
I'm good.
Last week was really bad, but I think today was better than last week. And don't ever listen to this man right here. I think you can do better. And he's afraid of stars as well.
Yeah, that's my man. Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Okay, and Principal Eric?
I think finding your voice is like a lifelong thing. I mean, throughout your career, it's something that we're always trying to do. Ask Atemi. It's a constant struggle that we're always trying to to overcome, you know, and I think you're on that journey right now. This was a great performance. It was a great song. You're an all-round entertainer, man. And
okay, you know what? Let's hear from Bior really quickly. Do you have anything to say to the judges or faculty?
Yeah, thank you very much for all the comments you gave me. They always brush me every day. They make me a better person. Like, I do better every single performance I make. It's all because of the comments, because I take them very serious. And thanks to East Africa.
Thank you, Dior. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, it's Tusker Project Fame Season 6, and we're bringing it, bringing it, bringing it. Back to social media here. I just got a tweet here from a gentleman called Sir Robbieville. He says, Dr. Mitch, please tell the cameraman to zoom in on Joey's dress. And this is another one from James. James says, I hear we should put Atemi in between Juliana and Ian just to block the color a bit.
Really?
Anyways, coming up, ladies and gentlemen, we got Nyambura coming up. It's happening on Tusker Project Fame Season 6 after this. Welcome back to Tusker Project Fame Season 6, and I'm chilling here with the hot sweetheart from Kenya. What's happening, babes?
I'm good, you?
You okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, people are complaining that they actually don't know the real you, Nyambura. So let's do another session of a couple of questions, Dr. Mitch. If I decided, say, maybe to say, let's go out and we go and hang, where would you take me?
Some place I eat back in school, it's called Mama Rosie.
Wait a second. You want to take me, Dr. Mitch, to Mama Rosie's?
Yeah, sure. It's still food.
Okay, and what would we eat? Huh?
There's meat.
Uh-huh.
There's madondo.
Uh-huh.
There is chapo. Seasonally, there's chicken. You know.
Okay, and what's your favorite part of a chicken?
Oh, it's the thigh. What? No. It's not the thigh. It's the gizzard.
Gizzard? Ew! Gizzard?
Yes,
especially. What do they call it? Frigisi?
Huh? Yes, frigisi. Especially when it's fried and then it's dried and then it's just put in your mouth. You just don't want to imagine.
Let's get on with the show. Because I see some people are not eating enough in the academy. Ladies and gentlemen, it is probably because she's focusing too much on food that she got on probation. Let's take a look at what happened last week.
This song is definitely not your style. That is what I'm going to say. I have seen you perform a lot better than this. This is not your best.
Wagwan, we will bring you straight from Kenya. The girl we call Nyambura, she will sing a song from Christopher Martin. It's called Cheetah's Prayer.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh Lord, don't let me cheat on my boyfriend. Cause as far as I can see, he loves only me. Oh Lord, don't let me cheat on my boyfriend. But Lord, if you can stop me from cheating, just don't. Situation. Me promise my guy to only look in his direction, but everywhere me turn, me see your next one, and my body gets weak and I ball for your attention. I only wanna give the boys what they want. My man thinks I'm wrong, but he won't understand. I don't want to lie, I don't want to cry, but I'm so very weak inside. Oh Lord, don't let me cheat on my boyfriend, cause as far as I'm tempted to think about my baby and another girl. And yo, it's hard, yo, it's hard, yo, it's hard to have one guy's kinda hard to play the part. He won't leave me if he knew what's in my thoughts. I hope I never ever pay that cost. Oh Lord, don't let me cheat on my boyfriend, cause as far as I can see, he loves only me. Oh Lord, don't let me cheat on my boyfriend, no, no. But Lord, if you can stop me from cheating, just don't.
Why I say, Njemieke, if you say blow, 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 blow. All right, so my first question goes to Judge Ian. Judge Ian, if you got caught, what would you say?
It wasn't me.
How was the performance, Ian?
A lot better, a lot better. You concentrated more on the singing and less on the theatrics, which is what you need to do. Let your voice carry the message. You don't have to act out everything the song is talking about. Much, much better.
Thank you.
All right. Atemi, what did you think of the performance?
I think one of the big problems I had last week is that you got so carried away with the song. Because, you know, it's a nice song, people like it. And you didn't put in that much effort. But today you sang, and I heard what you can do, and I realized that you're actually a really good singer. That was great.
Thank you.
Good job.
All right. Juliana, what do you think?
I think you really kept it real this time. Last week, your vocals were all over the place. I mean, like Atemi says, I think you just got so excited. This week was a proper performance. It was pleasant listening to you.
All right. And Edu, what do you think?
Nyambura, I think you did very well. Ian, I don't know what you keep talking about this theater. I'm not
theatrics.
Getting you.
I'll explain it to you, Omera.
Nyambura, let me tell Ian something. Ian is used to radio. He's not to see. So he keeps on listening. He just hears. He doesn't see. So you're fine.
All right. And Nyambura, what were you thinking when you were performing?
I was actually having a lot of fun, and when it comes to that song, man, when I get caught, I'll just like Ian, I'll say it wasn't me.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for Nyambura. All right, ladies and gentlemen, coming up after the break, we're going to find out who's going to be heading home. This is Tusker Project Fame, Season 6. All right, welcome back to Tusker Project Fame, Season 6. And if you're at home there, you're mulling and saying, how come they get to have all the fun? One of them is going to walk away with 5 million bob. What about me? What about me? Well, this time here, Tusker's taking care of you too. So all you got to do is, you know, take part in the underground promotion. And we've got two people who've walked away with, guess what, 500,000 shillings. We've got Alex Iboso and Angela Corrier. Man, congratulations to the both of you. But the question is, can't it be you two? Well, I think it can if you do this. Today's winning number is 79. So what you do is that you SMS this number together with the 6-digit code which you find underneath the bottle of your Tusker to the following numbers, 21001 if you're in Kenya or 8338 if it's in Uganda. Be one of the first people to SMS and you could win lots of great prizes with Tusker.
Okay. Well, now it's about that time that we start saving someone. So East Africa, who have you been voting for all week? Who's your favorite contestant out of those on probation? We are about to find out. Can I get everyone who's on probation to take the stage right now? That would be Nyambura, Bior, Sitenda, and Patrick. Go ahead and take the stage. And I'm going to be joined with the senior manager from PricewaterhouseCoopers. That is Frida Claire Katusia. Welcome. Okay, so PricewaterhouseCoopers have been verifying our SMS and online systems for Tusker Project Fame Season 6. So can you confirm that the results you have there have been verified?
The results I'm holding have been verified by PricewaterhouseCoopers.
Okay, and as we can see, the envelope is sealed. So let's go ahead and find out, East Africa, who you've been voting for this week. Go ahead and open the envelope, please. So with the highest amount of votes across East Africa, the person you've chosen to save is Nyambura! Congratulations! You're back in the academy. Thank you.
All right, so Nyambura, it looks like we're not going to Mama Rose's any soon, huh? How are you feeling right now, huh? Hey, okay, she's too ecstatic. Let's give it up for Nyambura.
Okay. So East Africa, you've spoken. You decided Nyambura is who you wanted to save, but who did the faculty save this week? Let's hear from Principal Eric. Who did you decide to save?
This individual has been working really hard, and we feel that they should never have been on probation in the first place. We are voting to keep Patrick.
Congratulations, Patrick.
Oh, Patrick, mon frère. Comment ça se sent? How are you feeling now?
I'm so grateful. I'm so excited. I'm grateful to the...
Let's give it up for Patrick!
Okay. Now remember, you can join us later on tonight from 10 p.m. for a rocking eviction party at Club Tusker being hosted at K1 Clubhouse in Westlands in Nairobi. That's from 10 p.m. tonight. But after the break, you need to stick around because the contestants of the Academy are going to save one of their own. Don't move.
West Africa, this is your girl, Modhoni, the drama queen, and this Sunday, Tusker Project Fame 6 is bringing you the biggest, baddest, hottest concert you have ever seen, all the way from Niger, Ice Prince and Brymo.
Yeah, we're dropping it like never before.
We're about to explode. Davido.
Digo, babe. Modigo Bay,
the Cocoa Master himself.
I'm the Cocoa Master. All the Cocoa Lutty better be there.
All the way from South Africa.
Teo from Mafiki Zolo.
Ceci Arose. Ceci.
All the way from Jamaica. Busy Signal.
Miss her, baby.
Big voice, ladies and gentlemen. Miss Elaine.
Me could never make it without you. Me coulda never make it without you.
From Kampala, Uganda. Jose Camilla.
Baby, nataka mina wewe two-way.
Radio and Wizzo.
It's all about the Luga flow,
Luga
yeah?
Flow.
You are magnetic.
Woo! Every song.
Magnetic.
And to celebrate with all these Africa superstars, all the way from the United States of America, Mr. Frank Ocean.
And do not think so far ahead.
Miss Katy Perry. From Kenya, a friend of mine, beautiful outer voice, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Fena.
They wanna know where I'm from, Africa, my silver.
Hey, yo, East Africa, we're going massive this Sunday.
So check it out, me, Modhoni, the drama queen, I'm opening the show this Sunday. First time ever live performance from MDQ. I'll be rapping, I'll be singing, I'll be on some reggae tip, you know. You wanna catch the biggest, baddest, concert in East Africa this Sunday on TPF 6. Act like you know.
East Africa, welcome back to Tusker Project Fame Season 6. So that was a sneak peek of how it's going down tomorrow. I cannot wait for the live show.
I want to stay home and watch
and
the show.
And just watch it at the concert. Modhoni, the drama queen, is going to be in the house from 7:30 p.m. live East African time. You don't want to miss tomorrow's show. It's going to be a hot probation show.
But before we get to tomorrow's show, we still got two contestants on probation. We've got Bior, we've got Sitenda, and we've got Patrick and Nyambura who are saved. So right now it's time for the contestants in the academy to save one contestant. Who's it gonna be?
Let's start with Fiona. Who are you voting for? For Sitenda. Okay, over to Daisy.
Daisy has voted for Sitenda. That's two for Sitenda.
Okay, Kojo, who are you voting
Kojo?
For?
Kojo has voted for Bjorn.
Okay, over to Hisia.
Hisia has voted for Sitenda. That's three for
okay,
Sitenda, one for Bjorn.
Hope votes for Bjorn.
Two for Bjorn, three for Sitenda.
Okay, Amos and Josh, vote for Sitenda.
That's four for Sitenda.
Okay, Fess votes for Bjorn. So it looks like Sitenda is safe in the academy for at least another week. Okay, so let's take a look at the life and times of Bjorn on Tuscan Project Fame.
Bjorn, give me some solo here. Some solo. Come on!
I was wearing high heels, man, for the girls, y'all. And I was looking so tall, but then it was hard to walk on the high heels. Man, I was looking like a lady, man.
Let me tell you, Mr. Ontes, there are nothing like the Ontes. If you will not just go Ontes, well, I cannot be near
Bjorn, I like everything, and I think you're a good entertainer, and I think everybody in South Sudan is happy with you, and I pray that you stay on today.
Okay, so sadly it's the end of the road for Bjorn, 4 weeks into the academy. How do you feel right now?
Yeah, first thing, I gotta thank South Africa, because they already made me a superstar. So I'll be walking out here a different person, not the same person anymore.
Yeah. All right. Best of luck to you, Bjorn.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you can continue checking out what's happening on Facebook. You can check us out. It's Tuskalaga. If you're on Twitter, it's hashtag TPF6. You can watch our YouTube channel. It's Tusker Project Fame Season 6. Or you can check us out online to vote at tusker.mobi at free of charge. And don't miss out on tomorrow's show. It's going to be hot. We've got the drama queen herself, man, Muthoni. It's going to be hot. So don't miss out.
Yes. So remember, Tusker Project Fame is broadcast by Citizen TV in East Africa. So catch tomorrow night's show at 7:30 p.m. East African time, live from Citizen TV or in Kenya. If you're in Uganda, you can watch us on Urban and TV West, EATV in Tanzania with a rebroadcast on ITV at 10 p.m. Rema TV in Burundi, Rwanda TV in Rwanda, Citizen TV in South Sudan, and a rebroadcast on SSTV at 10 p.m.
All right. So please join us for tonight's eviction party. It's going to be at K1 Clubhouse in Westlands in Nairobi. You get a chance to rub shoulders with one of the most talented guys I've ever seen from South Sudan, Bjorn, ladies and gentlemen. But as we say goodbye to him, he's going to show us standards doing a song called Gove by Davido.
Girl, your behind is a killer. I can't see your face, you are. See, go, babe. Almost see the way you wriggle and wave. You must be intentional. See, go, babe. Almost see, go, babe. No more, babe. Don't want any big girl. Motivo, see, you go, babe. I need your more kilo, deal, baby.